Hey guys, Corey here. Getting ready to start a cleaning here. They already did the vacuuming. I'm going to leave it at that because the cleaning is going to take a while. It's the worst case scenario, basically. It's a frisee and it is old, I would say at least 20 years. It's white and it's heavily soiled. So I did one room downstairs already just to speed the video along a little bit. Take a look at that when I'm done showing you the upstairs, but let me show you what's involved here. And I'm probably going to start in the master bedroom since it's not quite as difficult as at least two of the other rooms in the hall here. Two of the other rooms are beat all to hell and it's going to be awful to try to get them to come back to clean again. The stairs, thank goodness they're not in that terrible of shape. Then the room down there I just finished, you can see it looks pretty bright and shiny. All right, this room is probably in the best shape. It's got wrinkling. I wasn't asked to stretch, and I'm not going to recommend they stretch it because I just wind up doing it. I don't want to do it. It's take too damn long. So anyway, with this closet here, I don't know where the light is in the closet. It's anybody's business. Maybe this is it here. All right, it helps some. It's dated. The house is very, very dated. It's gonna go for a whole lot though. It's in a part of Austin that it's got a pool out there. It's got one of these, urinal. Anyway, you can see it's in Great Hills area, so you can see all the businesses and the buildings and stuff in the background. It's got a big pool out there and it's got really big trees and the landscaping has done really well. There is some upgrading here. This room is not terrible. The hall leading out of it to this other room is not terrible. Right here, heavily wrinkled, got a lot of wear in it. Now, this is where the problem comes in, right here. I don't know what was going on, but when you get to right here, you've got what looks like dog pee, heavy soil. They lived in these two rooms like they were mad. They had a desk set up in here and they beat the living hell out of the carpet all the way around the desk. So this is gonna take some scrubbing, a little bit of praying and heavy peroxide and a lot of LA's Totally Awesome to try to make that stuff release and get toweled out of there. That room, and then there's this room here, which is in just about a set of shape. I don't know if I can make the light work or not. That's not it. Turn the fan off. All right. Maybe there's no light in here. I don't know. That doesn't seem to be working. Anyway, you can see what I'm gonna try to do here. I'm gonna try to bring this back to Jesus here. So I'm gonna make the cleaning in the hardest parts of the house here. You know, these two rooms are what I'm gonna feature in the cleaning. The hard part, because the hard part is what everybody wants to learn about, is how to clean the difficult stuff. The easy stuff is where you make your money. You get to clean it, walk out and be done with it. This is where it slows you down and you don't make any money when you're cleaning a really difficult carpet. But if you can't clean difficult carpet, then you're not that good of a cleaner. You need to learn how to clean difficult carpet. This one I just did turned out really good. It was not quite as bad as the ones upstairs. You tell there was dog pee in it a little bit, but I bleached it really hard with peroxide and everything turned out fine. All right, I'm gonna do the master upstairs and the other room. And then when I finally get back to the camera, I'll be on those two rooms up there, the most difficult ones. So I'll be back in a bit. All right guys, we're gonna go look at what I just did. But now we're in the room that I'm gonna do right now, the most filthiest one here in the house. It's gonna be the most difficult to get clean. This is what we're gonna do next. So this will be a deciding factor here. I think I'm ready to claim that adding baking soda does increase your cleaning ability, I believe, because it's been just coming out of the dirt's been coming out of the carpet like crazy. I'll show you here. The two areas that I just did, right over here, there was one big urine spot here that as soon as I hit it with the peroxide, it went away. You got this room here. This turned out just beautiful, just perfect. There was a big urine spot over there that came right out just fine. And these, both of these rooms, I didn't actually do a pre-scrub on. I just polished the fibers in these two rooms. made them turn out really, really, really well. So I'm really happy with the way this turned out here. The fan is spinning like crazy, so it's drying it probably pretty fast. So let's get out here, doing the same thing. Dry that in no time. Now I'm gonna pull my machine over here. We're gonna spray this hall, this portion of the hall, and into this room. And these two rooms are gonna get the striped scrub pad first, because you're gonna try to sump all this out of the carpet and polish it out of the fibers. You're gonna have a real slow go of it. So you've gotta pre-scrub this. You've gotta pre-spray it more heavily than you normally would, and you've got to pre-scrub it, or else you're gonna be here forever trying to mop all of this soil out of the carpet. So let me pre-spray it. So basically I'm gonna hit it with a regular pre-spray, which is a little hopped up a little bit. And then on the traffic area, I'm gonna get the pre-spray that's basically just, it's hydrogen peroxide mixed with LA's Totally Awesome, which is that right there, really, really, really strong stuff. It's gonna get sprayed all around the perimeter of that, so we can get that out. So anyway, I'll be back when it comes time to do some scrubbing. All right, guys, got everything sprayed and it's ready to scrub, and we're gonna extract. So, I don't know if you can tell or not, but it has lightened up. Like this area here that was a really dark mark, it's lightened up quite a bit. And we continue to lighten up. We're gonna go ahead and speed up the whole process here. Let's see, this thing is probably gonna vibrate and shake. We're gonna put it in a closet here. See if I can sneak around it. All right, we're gonna scrub basically, you know, that's the main area. I don't need to scrub the entire room. I'm just gonna scrub the trouble area. I'm gonna scrub in the hall right quick, then come right through here to get all this. This is not ammonia this time. This is LA's Totally Awesome. Mixed it almost straight. Looks like it doesn't look like I'm going to get a complete extraction. Now I'm gonna change out towels and I'm gonna extract and we'll see what the soil looks like when it comes out of there. The other two rooms, I don't know if I show it or not, but that's what I got out of the other two rooms right there. That was bedroom, the master, and then that was the other bedroom there. So anyway, we're gonna put a new towel on and do this section of hall here and this whole room here. So I'll be back in a few when I get it all switched out and we'll watch the cleaning. All right, got the new pad on the machine, getting ready to do the extraction here. It's all sitting there wet, ready to clean. And you're gonna see a lot of soil come out of this, I'm pretty sure. I guess we're gonna probably have to move the camera around and we're not gonna get a complete extraction on this. We're never gonna make it match, but we'll see how close we can get. finish up the room here, come back and groom it, and we'll take a look at what I did, and we'll see what I think about the whole thing here. It's looking probably better than what I thought it would have. I have to attribute it to extra shot of LA's Totally Awesome and the baking soda, I believe. All right, I'm gonna go take a look. Clean that section of the hall. Now in here, it's not an exact match. The carpet in the middle is still brand new, but what I was able to do with it is just absolutely almost amazing. I think that might be, I don't know, almost damn near a new record. Because this is the frise, it's the most difficult to clean, and it's white. So that is extremely, extremely hard to do what I just did. The towel, I guess because the room was small, but it doesn't have really any more soil on it than the larger areas did when you look at those. Anyway, this is the last room here, and to make the video, you know, kind of smaller, I'm gonna show some of the cleaning. I'm not gonna show any of the pre-scrubbing. We're gonna show some of the cleaning and the grooming, and that's gonna have to be enough for this here. I think I'm gonna mix up some more pre-spray before I spray this one. So I'll be back. All right, let's watch a little cleaning here. half the room done. We get the other half. You can see it from here. Gonna groom here. Everybody's favorite. Shorten this guy up a little bit. That turned out extremely well. Need some stretching, but it's not going to be today. And this guy's dried a little bit. I'm really happy with this. This is extremely, extremely difficult soil to deal with, even if it wasn't white carpet. If it wasn't white, I think I could say we just had it just about perfect. But being white makes it just that much harder. The fiber type is just terribly, terribly difficult to make this frise come clean. It's something to do with, it was a little easier today, and the only thing that I did really different than I usually do is add baking soda. So that may have helped some. I think I'm ready to say it is worth adding to your pre-spray. All right, guys, appreciate you watching the video. It's pre-vacuum, so I didn't vacuum here because it was already done, and I needed the extra time to do all of the pre-scrubbing and stuff on these two rooms, so I opted to not do that on this video. But we'll be right back again tomorrow. I don't even know what I've got on my schedule tomorrow, but it's either cleaning or repair, one of those two. Thursday is going to be a big tile job, I think, out by the lake. Anyway, I've got the stairs to do. I'm going to close out the video now, but I've got the stairs to do, then I'm heading home. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless, and you're welcome to text me your questions. If you're interested in Challenger, you can get one through me, and I'll mail you a $100 rebate out of my commission check. Thanks for watching. God bless.